to strike down the admonition against alcohol, stating that it's all right to drink in moderation. The only line they drew was on the rim of drunkenness. But the fact of the matter is, if whatever you're drinking, whatever wine, if it's 5%, 10%, 15% alcohol, you're that much drunk. God help us. What condition is the church in today? We must have a revival. We must have a revival. We must have a revival. There is a darkness in the world. But I come this morning. I know that there are some bound by alcohol. I know there's some bound by drugs, homosexuality, whatever vice that or name you want to put on it. I know that you're watching and you're listening this morning. I have come this morning not to condemn you. I have come this morning not to rail against you or beat you up. I've come to tell you, though you have been in the darkness, there is a light. There is a light. There is a light, and His name is Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. I'm here to tell the alcoholic, you don't have to spend one more second bound by alcohol. You don't have to spend one more second bound by drugs. You don't have to spend one more day going from one rehab to another. There is a man, and His name is Jesus Christ. He is the light that shines in the darkness, and He can push back that darkness, and He can set you free in a moment's time. Hallelujah. Come on, praise the church. Listen. The Greek word for light here is phos, P-H-O-S. And it means underived. An absolute light, the opposite of all darkness. We are trying to treat the symptom. We are trying to try to adjust man's thinking. We're giving man philosophy. Philosophy has never set anybody free. There is only one who can not just curb the appetite, not just curb the appetite, but there is one who can break the appetite of bondage of sin, and His name is Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And this is what I've come to tell you today. You can put that whiskey bottle down. You can put that dirty magazine down. You can turn off that computer filled with pornography and never pick it up, never take another sip, never puff on another cigarette, never puff on another joint, never cram cocaine up your nose one more time. For whom the Son hath made free is free indeed. There is a light. There is a light. There is a light. There is a light that shines in the darkness. Hallelujah. Let me close. As the light sprung up that day in Galilee, so too must it spring up around the world. In other words, we got a job to do. Oh, you're not hearing me. The world is consumed in darkness. There is hatred and violence everywhere. Right this second, as I'm speaking to you, every second souls go to hell. Souls slip off into eternity. But they don't have to die and go to hell. Jesus Christ died on Calvary that the darkness may be pushed back and freedom may be there. I don't know about you this morning, but I'm so glad. I don't know who wrote this. I don't remember who wrote the song, but I'm so glad he did. I think it was Henry. I saw the light. I saw the light. No more in darkness. No more in fright. Praise God. I saw the light. I want you to know this morning, listen to me by radio and television. We have the message. We've got the message. We've got the message. Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Will you help us? Will you help us? Will you help us? Will you help us? There are souls that need saving. There are Christians that need baptizing in the Holy Spirit. There are sick bodies that need healing. And the only one that can do it is Jesus Christ. Oh, if I could sing this morning. I've already got the song picked out as our national anthem. If I could sing, this is what I would sing. There's a call. comes ringing over the restless wave. Send the light. Send the light. There are souls to rescue. There are souls to save. Send the light. The blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. We've got the light. We've got the light. We've got the light. And it's Jesus Christ. It's Jesus Christ. And He will save you in a moment's time. And the moment He saves you, old things pass away. All things become new. Because of the light. He's come. And the end result, singers, musicians, make your way back, of rejecting the light is spiritual death. Separation of God. Eternal damnation. We've got to reach the alcoholics. We've got to reach the drug addicts. We've got to reach the Muslims. We've got to reach the Buddhist. We've got to reach every tribe, every tongue, every kindred with the gospel of Jesus Christ. If the Lord wills it, and I'm praying about it, in the spring of next year, I will leave here. And I will go to a city called Kinshasa, the Democratic Republic of the Congo. It's been in perpetual civil war. Blood runs rampant. At any moment, fighting can break out. If you go to Kinshasa and you go to the capital city and you go outside the borders of the capital city and you wander the Congo, you will find village after village where women have had their arms hacked off. Men who have had their arms and legs hacked off, it is by machetes because of one tribe's hatred for another. It's on the America's watch list as being a dangerous place, and somebody said, you would go there? Absolutely. Absolutely. Why? Because they need Jesus. They need Jesus. Aren't you scared? No, I'm not scared. Because I'm bringing my bodyguards. God the Father. God the Son. And God the Holy Spirit. Because they've got to see the light. As your heads are bowed and your eyes are closed, no one looking around.
Praise God. Praise God.
I don't know the spiritual condition of every person who sits here. I know beyond a shadow of a doubt there's some by television, radio, internet.
Praise
You're not saved.
Praise God.
You live in darkness.
Praise God. Jesus.
But I'm not going to close this service out without not only appealing to you, but also to those of you in the sanctuary. As I look around, I see faces that I do not know. They're not familiar to me. And I pray that every person who sits here is a child of God. But I want you to know we don't have much time left. If you're here today and you're in darkness, you're not here by accident. The Holy Spirit has drawn you to this light. Because today is your day of salvation. Jesus stands before you in the spirit world. His arms are open wide. And He's saying, do you come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He loves you this morning. And you don't have to spend another second in darkness bound by sin. I'm going to pray and I'm going to ask the convicting power of the Holy Spirit to speak to every heart. You may be a backslider here this morning. I want you to know you've come to the right place. He will in no wise cast you out. He holds His arms open, bidding you come. Don't let this moment pass you by. They that sit in the region of the shadow of death, light has